something that everyone's probably experienced in school. It's sonnets and prose poems and rhymes. And code is something that a lot of people might not have experience with. Code poetry is poetry that's in programming format. I combine them by taking the structure of code, which looks a very particular way, and putting poetry into that structure. I line up expressions and thoughts and dialogue with certain people, and I line up actions in a different way. I've never taken a semester with both information science classes and English classes, so last semester I did, and I found my work bleeding into each other, so I found myself writing code analysis with prose and writing poetry with code.
This is a poem called Private Self, and it's describing the self for someone who's in computer science and English.
When many of the students, and even when I first read one of her code poems, which was in the fall when she was in my advanced creative writing workshop, I didn't quite know what to make of the work at first, because I haven't studied computer programming. And the more she's kind of explained the relationship, the more I see how she sees the poetry and the narrative and the story inside of the programming.
I'm working on my capstone project for English right now, and half of that is in code poetry, and I do it in that way to tackle the problems of being both a woman in programming and being an English major and an information science major.
One of the things that her project did was not only teach me new ways of thinking about how these two disciplines might relate, but also how her education has worked.
I think it's a great way to tackle the issues that we face as a society. Like, there are so many gender normative issues within programming and STEM in general, and then as someone who's involved in all of these fields, I think that it really needs to be known that this is very difficult and it shouldn't have to be. By writing this poetry, I hope that people will see that and react to it.